Well, hello everyone. I know it's been such a long time, but here we are again, back playing Fading Hearts, and I've missed this game. And to be totally honest with you, I've forgotten most about this game, so this is going to be fun for everyone, I should imagine. I'm here with, as you probably just heard there, the lovely Laura.
Say hi.
And the wonderful April.
Hi.
And you can argue later on about who got the best introduction.
We both won because we get to be here with you, Simon. So,
pile it on thick, why don't you?
let me get a trowel.
Right. So we've gone through this game. We finally got through to a chance to actually do something. We can use the computer. We can check the bookshelf. We can rest, or we can go outside. Any preference,
let's
guys?
Let's go outside.
Okay, it's one for going outside. Yeah.
Sure, let's go outside. Laura seems enthusiastic about it.
All right, Tachibana Park.
Tachibana.
Don't touch my banner. That's wrong. I can read, relax, or go to the forest from here.
The forest?
Not the forest. Don't go into the forest. There have been reports of shadowy monsters in the forest. It's probably a prank, but it still could be dangerous in the air.
Oh, it's dangerous.
Sorry, yes. Dangerous. Right, should we read or go somewhere else?
That's up to you.
I'll go somewhere else.
Let's go somewhere else.
Let's explore the forest.
Okay, welcome to the last episode of Fading Hearts. Since it's night time, the woods are undoubtedly crawling with predators. Let's do it. Let's see what happens. Various people claim to have seen monsters here. Most likely it's the product of a lone wolf and someone's wild imagination. Still, it never hurts to be careful. If something weird happens, I can always run. I hope.
Got your trainer on.
Shall I explore farther? Yeah. My mind starts to drift away. Yeah.
Must be those cookies he had before you left.
And here we have the up-and-coming Shining Long Blade. This will be her last match in the immediate league. Actually, it's totally wrong voice for this. And here we have the up-and-coming Shining Long Blade. This will be her last match in the Intermediate League. So let's send her off with a big round of applause. Yay!
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
She's the first outsider to make it this far, and she's sure to go further yet. Let's keep an eye on this rising star.
Late.
At last, we'll be joining the Elite Division. I've worked so hard for this, but I can't stop here. I have to keep going. I have to win, no matter what.
I think that's her.
I can finally wield an A-rank magic. Everyone told me... Yes, okay. Who wants to do this voice?
I can finally wield A-rank magic. Everyone told me it was impossible, but I mastered it in the shortest time it's ever been done.
Thank you, Laura. That was really good.
Did you say Laura? Because I did not
hear
that.
I didn't. No.
You're just being funny.
Failing is not an option.
Or get one or the other. And now, let the match begin! Yay! Yeah, okay.
Failure was never an option.
What?
Well,
I'm confused.
That makes no sense whatsoever. Hopefully it will someone.
So weird.
My head hurts. Should we do it again, or should we go home?
Well, it's explore further, so it's going further again, so...
No, it's a typo. Should we explore farther?
I don't want to explore my father. No, thanks.
Okay. Let's try it one more time, shall we?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I walk around the forest for a while. Ellipsis.
Ellipsis.
I don't see anything except trees and glass.
We've been doing this too long.
Let's go home.
Okay.
Sigh.
It looks like a nice bed.
Yeah, it's not a bad bed at all, really, is it? Today was definitely more exhausting than I'd bargained for. Well, tomorrow, I'll be having bubble tea with Claire and Rena. I wonder if I should tell them about our label as the Big Three.
I want bubble tea.
What's bubble tea?
It's like a... It's tea that has these... They're called boba. They're big balls of tapioca. And then you get this huge... you get this huge straw and you suck the balls of tapioca through and it's like sweet tea. It's a cold drink. It's really good.
All right, okay.
It's tea, but here is the clever bit. It has bubbles. I might as well go to sleep now. Nothing else better to do.
Aw.
I turn out the lights and drift off out the window. Should we toss a coin? Has anyone got a three-sided coin?
Laura, go ahead.
I can't remember the voice. Oh, don't say Scottish. I can't remember. Ryou, I have something to show you.
I'm having a dream from years ago about a much younger Claire and myself.
Hey, Claire, there we go.
She places something in my hand, careful to keep it concealed as she does.
Her heart.
Then it starts burning through my palm. I think you were, Claire, yes. At least you are now.
Alright.
Who's who? I'm confused.
I'm pretty sure you're Rena and I'm Claire.
I'm fairly uncertain about who I am at the moment. Not even yet.
You're Ryou.
No, I'm Simon. I'm fairly... Actually, I believe I'm Simon. I might be wrong. Does anyone know where I live?
England.
Will you be my mummy?
You in that nappy again, Simon?
Shh, you're not supposed to tell anyone. Then she moves her hand away and I peer downward curiously.
Why?
Unfortunately, she's wearing a tight top. Something slimy leads up in my face and I yelp in surprise. Yelp!
I'm trying to be quiet.
No, I don't get that one.
I'm gonna die. Oh my
god. Claire giggles helplessly at my reaction.
It looks like Simon likes you.
Claire! Her pet frog has now landed back on my hand. I glare at it reproachfully.
But you know what happens when you kiss a frog? It turns into a prince.
I thought it turned into a cold sore, okay. Seeing her smirk, I feel a sudden urge to even the score. I hold the frog right up to her face. How'd you like that? Her mouth just curls into a smile.
Why, thank you, Ryou. I'm glad you returned my pet frog to me.
I think it's the curse of the person who's actually doing the narrating. I must do all the lines. She takes him from me and strokes him happily as he wiggles in her hand. Yeah.
Simon likes it.
Yeah. Then she looks back at me, puzzled.
You know, this is my frog. Why would you think that I would be scared of him?
I stare back for a moment. I guess I didn't really think this through.
There, Ryou. I'm sure you'll be able to get back at me someday.
Claire pats me on the back consolingly. Behind the schoolyard, I can faintly hear the muffled sound of someone crying. As I walk around the corner, I search for the source. I come across Claire sitting in the shadow of the school building. She's curled up against the wall, her face buried in her hands. Worried, I jog over to her. Claire! What's wrong?
Simon. He died.
She no. manages to say weakly between sobs. Who? You mean your frog? She nods, her face still hidden in her hands. We wait in silence for a moment before she speaks again.
Well, go ahead, laugh at me.
Her words make my head snap up in surprise. What? Why would I do that?
I made fun of you with Simon, didn't I? So you should be happy now that he's gone.
Claire. I kneel beside her and pat her on the head. I wanted to eat him one day, but apart from that... I'm not going to laugh at you. What kind of friend does that? Claire looks up at me. Her eyes are red and swollen from crying. I wouldn't pick on you. I wouldn't laugh at you. I want to see you happy. And when you cry, it makes me want to cry too.
Oh,
so please smile, Claire. Your smile makes me smile too.
That's emotional blackmail right there.
Anyone who's suffering from diabetes may want to skip ahead at this point. Without any warning, she tackles me and throws her arms tightly around me. The sheer force of it bowls me over. We land on the grass in a tangled heap. And at that point, I became a man. But even so, she makes no move to stand and continues clinging to me desperately. This is the first time I've ever been so close to an ellipsis. A girl.
Yeah.
She finally whispers into my ear. Stop sticking me there.
Even though I was mean to you, you're being so nice to me. I don't deserve it.
Yes, you deserve being stuck there. My only answer is to hold her tighter in my arms. As time passes, her shallow breathing levels out to an even rhythm.
Ryou, you can't stay like this forever. People as trusting as you always get hurt in the end. I don't know what I'd do if someone hurts you. Oh, is that me again?
Might as well be.
Please.
Do you think that their budget for drawings was out at that point?
They use stock art.
Yeah, but it's only like they've only used 5 so far anyway. Yeah. Good morning. Sorry, what? I'm not going to do that again.
Oh my god, I'm sorry.
Simon Frog,
right? He was like so into it there, wasn't he? You could feel his whole body was into that.
I just can't work under this pressure. Where's my agent? Right. Are we good? Yes. Can I start?
Yes. Kenny was asking me a question.
Well, thank Kenny for blocking my flow. Mm-hmm. Good morning, Trident City. Today will be bright and sunny skies, so up and at 'em. The thunderstorm approaching is still on track to hit late Sunday evening. I don't know what Sunday evening did to deserve it, but...
Oh my god, Simon.
Please, just shut up. It's way too early in the morning for this. It's Thursday, but it's also Professional Development Day for teachers. School for teachers and not for us. So I can afford to sleep a little longer. I close my eyes and doze off again as I think of the irony of it all. I wake up just in time to get ready to meet Claire and Reiner at the bubble tea shop. I lock the door and head out. I arrive at... Sorry?
Reiner.
Ah, sorry, yes.
Not Reiner. It's like a rhinoceros.
Well, you've seen her nose, haven't you? I'm in so much trouble for that one. I arrive at the shop on time. Now, where are they?
Hey, looks like you made it on time for once.
What one is... What? Who's who?
You're Reiner, Rena, Reiner.
No, I know, but...
I'm the one with the dark hair.
Ah, okay. Hi, Ryou. Or Ryou, whatever it is.
Yep.
We're over here.
Just think of it like a bark. Roo!
Roo!
No, you got it right the second time.
I join up with my two closest friends. They're both in high spirits from the look of things. Hey, Claire. Hi, Rena.
Let's hurry up and order. I want a strawberry milky bubble tea with tapioca pearls.
chocolate banana milky bubble tea with strawberry jelly. Woo!
Hey, don't tell me. Tell the woman at the cash register.
What, you're not buying?
Yeah, I don't think he's quite worked how it works. We order a
drink. They both look so annoyed.
I know.
Yeah, you can just see that. That's Rena's annoyed face.
Yep.
Rena looks less annoyed.
And unfortunately, that's Claire's happy face. We order our drinks and claim a booth for ourselves, and that is where we've run out of time.
Oh.
So good doing this again. Thanks a lot, guys.
That was good. Had a nice, be easy. Two lines. I'm just along for the ride tonight.
But hopefully we'll be doing a lot more of these, and there's more characters involved, and we find out who she was, who was doing the magic, and all sorts of things. Yeah. All sorts of things.
Yeah, life's back on track, so stuck with us now.
Such a terrible thing to happen. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Please leave a like, please leave a comment, let us know what you think, what characterizations we got wrong because we just couldn't remember them, what you'd like to see happen, everything. Just tell us what you had for lunch, really don't mind.
Yeah.
And don't forget, if you want to vote for the live stream on Wednesday, what you play will get shown on my YouTube channel. So even if you don't watch the live stream, it's probably a good idea to go and see what you want to play. And I'll see you all tonight. Say goodnight, everybody.
Good night. Bye, guys.
Bye. Thanks. Bye.
Bye. Bye.